Back to STS. In today's video, we're going to find the vertex of a quadratic equation using various methods. Let's begin by working with the calculator, the TI-84 plus. Let's go ahead and press Y equals, and you'll see I have the quadratic equation already in place. The quadratic equation already in place. 2x squared minus 4x plus 6. So let's go ahead and graph that. All right, we see the yellow circular item there moving, so we know it's still calculating. Here we have our parabola. We see it's opening in an upward position, and we see that the vertex here appears to be at position 1, 4. Let's go ahead and zoom in so we can get a better look at this first quadrant. So let's click on zoom. Let's press alpha and then math for just the first quadrant, and again we see it better here, over one position for x and then up four positions for y. And lastly, let's look at the table. I'm going to hit second and then graph. The table comes up, and again we're expecting it to be 1, 4. We know that it's 1, 4 because we see symmetry about this point. We see that to the left and right of this point we see a 6 and a 6, then 12 and 12, 22, 22, and so forth. So we can be pretty self-assured that that is in fact the vertex. Let's go ahead now and work on some methods to come to the conclusion of the vertex by hand. Alright, we begin by writing the formula, and that is f of x is equal to 2x squared minus 4x plus 6. We're going to go ahead and work with the calculus method first and take the derivative of this function. So here f prime of x is equal to, we keep this coefficient of 2, we know the exponent has to come down, so the 2 comes down, we keep the x, and we have to decrement the power, so it goes from 2 to 1. Minus, we keep the factor of 4, and we know that the derivative of x is just 1, and the derivative of any constant, here we have 6, that is 0. So we can place the 0 here, and now let's simplify this. 2 times 2 to give us 4, and we keep the x, minus 4 times 1 to give us 4. So here we see that f prime of x is equal to 4x minus 4, and this here is the expression for the slope of the tangent line. We know that our parabola is going in an upward position, 1 because we saw it on the graph, and 2 because we know that with the quadratic equation, if the x squared term is greater than 0, then it opens in an upward position. All right. With that, we know our point of tangency is down here at a minimum value, and we know that the slope of the tangent line at this point should be 0. So we're going to set this expression equal to 0. So we have 0 is equal to 4x minus 4. I'm going to add 4 to both sides as I simplify trying to find the value of x. Those cancel, and I have 4 is equal to 4x. To find x now, I divide both sides by 4. These x's cancel, so I'm left with just an x. And here 4 divided by 4 gives me 1. So I found the x value of this vertex to be 1. And now let's take this value of x and substitute it back into the original equation. Every place that we see an x, we're going to substitute that for the number 1. So here we have 2 times 1 to the second minus 4 times 1 plus 6. We're going to follow our order of operations into our exponents first. 1 to the second power is 1, and 1 times 2 gives me 2, minus 4 times 1 to give me 4, and I tack on my plus 6. From here, I see that 2 plus 6 gives me 8. I still have my minus 4, and 8 minus 4 gives me 4. So I just found that my vertex, using the calculus method, is at position 1, 4. Now let's move on to use a more algebraic method. And let's begin by, let's first change the color. And let's place the standard form of the quadratic equation. And that's ax squared plus bx plus c is equal to 0. In this example, we see that a is 2, we see that b is negative 4, and we see that c is 6. The expression we're going to use to find the values for x and y are going to be negative b over 2a, that gives us x. And if we take that expression and make that the input back into the function, we'll find the value for y. So that's f of negative b over 2a. So let's begin by finding x. We know we have a negative on the outside, and we have a fraction to work with. The value of b is negative 4. And we have a 2 as a coefficient. Let's place that in there. And the value of a is 2. So now let's simplify. keep the negative on the outside, I still have my negative 4, and now I have 2 times 2 to give me 4. And when I begin to simplify, I have my negative on the outside. Negative 4 divided by 4 is negative 1, and a negative times a negative 1 gives me a positive 1. So that there is my x value. And again, if I substitute that value of x back into the original equation, here we've already proven that it's going to come out to have a value of 4. So again, we found the vertex to be at 1, 4 using the quadratic method using the properties of a quadratic equation. And lastly, let's change the color one more time. And now let's use another algebraic method. Actually, it's going to be completing the square. When we complete the square, we know that we should have a equation in the form f of x is equal to a times the quantity x minus h squared plus k, where our vertex is going to be hk. Here we have h and the k. So let's begin by rewriting the original function. So we have 2x squared minus 4x plus 6, and I'm going to set that equal to 0. First step is to get that constant out of the way, so let's subtract 6 from both sides. It cancels here, and we have 2x squared minus 4x is equal to a negative 6. Next thing I notice is I can factor out a 2, so in doing so I'm left with x squared minus 2x, and I know I need to add on a constant, so let's just leave a blank, is equal to negative 6, and I know I need to add that same constant here off to the right-hand side. Now let's go ahead and use the completing the square method. I need to take the coefficient of the x term, which is negative 2. I need to take half of that, and then I need to square it. Here I have negative 2 divided by 2 to give me a negative 1, and when I square that, negative 1 squared gives me a value of 1. So that means on the left-hand side I'm going to place a 1, but because I factored out a 2, I'm actually adding 2 to the left-hand side because 2 times 1 is 2. So now I'm going to add that 2 to the right-hand side, and now I've just created a perfect square trinomial on the left-hand side. So my factor on the outside is 2, and I'm using x minus 1. This minus 1 comes from this step here as I completed the square. I know this quantity is going to be squared, and then I resolve this. Negative 6 plus 2 actually gives me a negative 4. At this point, I need to set everything equal to, I need this set equal to 0, so I need to move everything to one side of the equation. Let's go ahead and add 4 to both sides. And adding 4 to both sides, that cancels going to 0. On the right-hand side, I'm sorry, on the left-hand side, I have 2 times the quantity x minus 1 squared, and that's plus 4, and this here is in my vertex form. So now I see that h is going to be 1, because again I'm going to take the opposite sign of what I see here in the parentheses, just like I showed up here, and then I'm going to keep the sign with the term for k, and we see it's positive, and that's going to be a 4. So here we've just proven that the vertex is still at position 1, 4, and we've used a calculus method, we've used a method that uses the properties of quadratic equations, and we've used the algebraic method of completing the square. That sums up this video, and as always, thank you for watching.